That's a big fish, this one.
That is a Scotch pie. And if you're ever in Scotland, you've just got to make sure you eat these consistently, all the time. Maybe one every hour. That's what's occurring now. This is what's going in me. That is looking great.
That's a big fish by its bollock.
Today is all about skate fishing. And eating, of course.
At the moment, we've got like 50 mile an hour easterlies, northeasterlies. So yeah, come about 11 o'clock, we should have the weather dropping out and a window of calm and a really nice slack water from around 11 o'clock to about 1:30. So just using an octopus bait with a tiny slither of herring on it. Oh, here it goes.
So we're going skate fishing. There. Off there, right there, by there today now.
And that is the skate up and over that I use with a bait that's going back out that's just caught a skate. 10 ounce lead, 100 pound shock leader onto 80 pound braid, a spin fisher 75,000 and a Sentry fire blade. There you go.
And now it's a game of just letting loads and loads of line off. It's pretty deep. So I'm letting a lot of line off.
So the lead's still dropping at this point.
There we go. There's my marker coming through.
Of the session, been about 20 minutes. We're on. It's taken nearly all my reel before I noticed it. The ratchet's not been working, but look at that. That is skate on. Need to get some line back on this reel. In. Jeez, if that goes off, I'm in trouble.
A bit concerned here. I've got nothing prepared.
I need to get my gloves, the gaff, and other things sorted, like the other rod in the background. I need to wind that in before I get snagged up on it.
At the moment, it's just peeling line slowly, look.
This is going to be a little bit of a long video. I do apologise in advance, but I think that most of it is relevant and it might aid someone to land a skate in the future. One of the reasons is that it seems to snag up quite a lot. You'll find out why at the end of the video, but it's always worth persevering and letting that fish run.
This is where you need someone with you, really. But right, back is playing out not at the right time. So yesterday, when I arrived, I was so tired after driving through the night. I fished for a bit and had a few spur dogs. Made some food and coffee and just relaxed a bit. And it got to the point yesterday where I was so tired I didn't fish for these, because if I hooked into them, I don't know if I'd be able to do it. And at the moment, I'm quite glad I had a good night's sleep, because this one, this is pretty solid. It just flew off. The ticker on the reel stopped working for some reason, so I didn't hear anything. I just looked around and the rod's just going, the reel's just spinning away. Really be prepared now. I should have my gloves on, gaff ready. Now this is a good girl. I'm in trouble here a little bit. Right, so what do I need to do? Just sorting everything out. I'm so unprepared, it's unbelievable. So this one's got a skate on and it's just stuck to the bottom. This one I'm getting in, get out of the way, hoping there's nothing on it now. then.
Well, this is all going on. I've still got that poofed over skate on that. There's a quick time to have a coffee before the rod goes over. What's funny is I just messaged my friend because he hooked up last night. And I said, what time? I bet you it's about 11 o'clock. And it's bang on 11, where the tide's just changing on low water. So that's that, that's that. So I think I've got to try and heave this up now. So if I go, I'll go here. Just touch the back here to see what we're looking like. Cool, we got enough battery and so on. I think that's good enough.
Right, I think it's about time to unleash a bit of hurt on this and get it moving. Yeah, here she goes. Tighten the drag up.
Line out. So it's not snagged, it's just sat on the bottom and it's clawed its way into the gravel or whatever's down there. It drags so tight, I can't even turn the handle. It's either that or I've got no power left in me from hardly any sleep.
getting somewhere. Moving out slowly but just. Again, same rods as last year. Made by Michael at Mars Custom Rods in Wales. Mike does a superb job. This is only a cheap fire blade, but it's transformed it into a monster. The amount of pressure through my front foot at the moment and on my knee is incredible.
post behind me that you can use just to give your rod a bit of purchase. But one, it puts a very pressurized point where it rests on the stump on the rod, and it could snap things. But that's the easy way out. I'm trying to do it with no aid like that, because the times that we want to come up to Scotland and catch these things, sitting at home, the times we want to catch these things up in Scotland and we're sitting at home miles away from it, I thought I'd make the best of the situation and do it the hardest way I can. You never know, this could be the last skate I catch today. So just using an octopus bait with a tiny slither of herring on it. Oh, there it goes. Don't look. This is a good fish, you know. It's probably on par with the big one I caught last year. That was funny. I think it did. It did 11 times up and down that fish did. And I think this is going to be similar. So, they're out here and I'm here. And I'm lifting them up and then they end up going back a bit. And I lift them in, sort of dragging them along the sand bed. And then they go back again down the slope. And normally you can tell how big they are by how many times they come up and down again. This one's run straight away and it's not moved a lot. I've gained probably about 40 yards on my reel. Oh. 30, 20, 10. That's so tight on there. Reel on the rod. Oh, that was a big reverse then. Oh, that was like, no way, I'm not going your way. Doof. Mind you, that could be a sign it's giving up a bit. that's now close to shore, but vertical. So the weight has changed from dragging it to dead solid. And now I'm just starting to try and get it up. So it's a pump vertical, so if you can keep it going, you'll get it up. As long as it doesn't turn like this. Shoot, that's an awful lot of drag. There it is. Go on, just get it to turn up. Go on. There it is. So I'm watching the tip when I load it. If that tip's rising, I know that's when I can actually go to town on it. If that tip stops and goes back down, I can't really do any more on the reel. So it saves getting up ready for a pump when you can't do it. Wow. This is some trust on their knots. So I'm actually using Gardner 100-pound shock leader because it's really supple and good for casting. And that's on an FG knot to this, I think is 79-pound spider wire. So I don't want to push it too much. Really, why it wants to turn. I think we're nearly up. If I let this go now, it'll go all the way back down, and that's an awful lot of fighting to get it back up. So this is where it's really is the fish against me, or me against the fish. So I've just got to keep the hurt on as much as I can. I'm not that far away where I am. That's a big one. on. Close. I just want to see leader. My left foot is hurting. Right, last pump. It's got to be nearly shock leader. Not snagged. He's going. That's a big fish, this one. Looks like he's huddled on the floor. What I'm going to do is release a bit of the drag. And see if he starts going away again. And I can bang him back up. But I think he's got himself into a spot. So, what I'm waiting for is him to decide to swim away again. And then I can give it a good pump again. Slack. Well, that's what we come for anyway. So I'm going to see if I can get it out now after about five,
10 minutes of leaving it. If I can't, I'll bring you back when I can. It's only, it's right there. It's not out there, it's right there. Sat on the floor.
It seems like the fish is snagged here, but that is not the case. All it's done is it's buried itself in a bit of gravel or sand at the bottom.
So, try to get it out. So we're gonna put it back on the rest with a loose drag and see if it'll come out itself.
So, this fish has come from over there and then I've pulled it in close to where I was and it's been vertical but it's been stuck on the floor. So what I've done is I've walked down the pier here and brought the line over the top of the fish, I think, to then put a bit of pressure on it now from this angle to see if I can convince it to get up off the floor. Hopefully I can get it moving. Go on. Get on. No, it's still stuck fast. So after a while, the fish is still sitting on the floor. You can see my rod is absolutely compressed into this with maximum drag, and I'm holding the reel as well. So I'm probably over 25 kilograms of drag on this at the moment, just trying to annoy the fish off the floor. I know it's not snagged.
God, this thing just doesn't want to go off the floor. It moves. I grab the rod, tighten up, and it just sits. Oh, God. So it's finally free. It's starting to run, look. I'm just going to let it run. Just a little, because it's been caught up. Nice, so I just want to keep a bit of slack. I want to feel him actually move before I start to pull him back up, because he keeps digging himself in. This is quite a big fish. We've only had a couple do this. It's not snagged, it's just, it just grips to the floor. Let some slack out. Just see if it's freed itself. Let's see if we can get it off. Right. Yeah. It's there. We've got it up. This is a big boy. I don't want it to get any more line. Yes. You notice I'm holding the reel. There's so much power on that line.
We're focusing on that rod tip under compression. We want to see that tip moving up slowly, so we know we're moving the fish. If it's snagged or stopped, you'll see that the rod compresses and the tip stays stationary.
This is a good fish. This was worth the wait. Gosh.
That's solid. There's so much pressure on that just to lift it. That's not snagged. There it goes. Gosh, this is a big one. Sorry about my breathing. I think this is probably the biggest one I've had. That's unbelievable. Literally dead winching it. I'm not going to say it, but I don't want this to run anymore. I'm knackered. I think it is as well. Literally a foot time. No. Should be at leader now. Legs are like jelly. Thank you. big mover. Gotta keep going, but my legs were giving up. I want to see Leda. Please. This is one hell of a fish. Slowly but surely. Well, I think this one's enough for the year. Don't want any more like this. Oh, he's on a snag, look. Come on, it's got to be there now. It didn't cast that far out. Is that in a snag? No, it's moving. It's coming. Ah. Get out the front door. Here we go. Just watching that tip lift. Don't know how long I can sustain this pressure on my knee. It's just there. I should see leader now. You see my legs shaking. That can't be far away. God, what a good fish. This is a biggie. God, that was a big lift up then. I'm looking at my line on my reel. I think I'm nearly at leader. But I think it's picked the snag up off the floor. So even though I was lifting it quite smoothly, you could see some jarry movements on the tip of the rod. Let's see if this lunges off now. Give it a bit of slack there. Go on, do a little lunge, mate. Let it free itself. There it goes. Just giving it a go. So what I'm looking for is a nice lunge of the fish. Got a lot of pressure on it. But I think it's got a bit of snag, so I think there's a line coming from the bottom snagged up and it's wrapped itself in it. So, it'd be interesting to see how far down this drops. So I'm letting some slack out. Here we go, it's starting to swim, so tighten up the drag. And what it should do, if there's any snags, it'll actually pull itself loose as it's moving quite quick. I'll tighten that up and I'm going to hit into it again. Go this way. Let's see if I can get it up now. And now I can start moving that, look. See the tip rising? Yeah. Yeah, that's on a snag. So what we'll do is let this run really quick, let it go free, and it'll actually snap itself out of that. There we go, look. It doesn't know what's happened to it yet. I've dropped the lead down. Yeah, so that doesn't know what's happened to that yet. So what I'm looking for now is that fish to go and swim away and give us some head lunges. If it can get moving, it'll snap itself out of that. Here we go, look, it's actually, yeah, it's got itself out. It's swimming away. It's out, it's on the surface. I can see leader for the first time. Probably one of the most epic fights I've had with a skate here. Got a little bit of colour then. There we go. Oh, it's a big boy. Look at that. It's foul hooked. Oh dear. What is it with foul hooking these things? Right. I've got to move this around to there. And look at that. There you go, Shane, the magic step. Oh, by its bollock. That's a big fish by its bollock. Oh no, that's not. Not good, it's really got him, hasn't it? the gaff. And then pause, because I've got to do this quickly. Keep pressure on him. Right. Sorry, Rod. Sorry, Rod, if anything happens to you. If it goes, it's just gonna flatline. Drag off that. There we go. Gosh, that's a big, big male. Oh gosh, that's a nice male. Unfortunately, it's been foul hooked. I'll be able to really like getting these fish out of the water. Right in it. Right in its bit. Let's see if I can feel the hook. There we go. Well, you gave me a good fight, mate. And it's because it was foul hooked there, look. These are awesome.
Well, there we go. That's a nice fine male specimen. After a while you tend to not want to measure them or anything. It's just about getting coming up here for an adventure, and then when it pays off it comes good. They're lovely creatures. So I'm going to put my hand on its head and send it on its way.